Hey babes, what's up and welcome back. It's your girl Midnight Moon and today we're gonna be doing another makeup tutorial. So if you wanna see how I did this cake liner slash neutral eye look, then just keep on watching. I can make your dreams come true, but let me get this straight, don't ever need no
matter, tell me what to do. First, I'm mixing my concealers to create my base. So I'm taking the e.l.f. Cosmetics 16-Hour Camo Concealer in the shade Tan Sand and the Maybelline Master Conceal in Light Medium to do this. Now I'm gonna take the Naked Urban Decay Wild West palette and I'm gonna be taking the same brush that they gave me in this palette. We're gonna take the shade Spur. And on the fluffy ended brush, we're going to tap that excess product off and then blend it out around our eye as our transition shade. If you guys don't follow me on Instagram, you can do so now. My screen name will be in the screen here. Now I'm taking the shade Ghost Town and I'm using that to darken up that transition shade just a little bit. Also, if you haven't yet, please subscribe. Also, like this video if you enjoy makeup tutorials. Let me know in the comments if you like these tutorials and if you're enjoying the one that you're watching right now. Now we're gonna take the shade Whiskey, which is a darker brown, and we're gonna take that along the outside corner of our eyes to deepen that crease a little bit more. Just make sure you blend all of the colors out. Don't use too much of a heavy hand because you won't get the proper distribution that you want. Taking this really pretty gold, which is called Hold'em from this palette, and I'm using this all over the lid of my eye, not really as a cut crease, but going in the same direction as that. As you can see, I'm literally just going in the inner corners of my eyes and right along the eyelid. Going back in with Ghost Town and Whiskey, mixing these two a little bit and using this right back on the outside corner since we put that really pretty gold on there. Now I'm taking the Dollar Lash Club Aqualiner Pastel UV Cake Liner in Peach. This is so pretty and I'm just taking this with a small skinny brush and mixing it with water to my consistency. You don't want it too thick, you don't want it too thin, you want it just right. And I'm just taking this right along my crease, not in the crease, but just a millimeter above it. I'm also taking the liner and doing the same thing on the bottom. So right underneath the lash line starting and bring it up to that point on the liner. Then just fix up what you need to. Also, if you guys are interested in a discount on these liners, I am an affiliate with Dollar Lash Club, so you can check out the link in my description. If you click the link, I earn a small percentage of whatever you guys buy without any additional cost to you. You guys also receive a percentage off your order, and that's the best part. So now I've curled my lashes and now I'm taking the Lily Lashes. This is the new collection available at Sephora. And this is the style Luxe from their Light Fox Mink collection. I'm also taking the Chiseled Beauty Adhesive Lash Glue. This is by far one of the best glues I've used. This is a clear glue. And I'm also taking a lash applicator to go ahead and do my lashes. I love this style for this look because it's really simple, cute, and fluttery. Now I'm taking the Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara, one of my favorite mascaras ever, and I'm just lining up the top of my lashes to let them blend in with the falsies, and And I'm taking the mascara as well on the bottom of the lashes to lengthen them out to give them a bit more volume and drama. Now I'm taking the CoverGirl Perfect Point Plus, and I'm just using this to tightline my eyes and the eyelashes on them. So you see, I'm just bringing it a tiny bit right over the lash line so it evens out. And I'm also gonna add some inner corner lines to make it look more cat eye-ish. This liner is so easy to work with when you're doing stuff like this. Now I'm taking the Aflano contour and highlight palette, and I'm taking this really pretty shade right here. It's like an orangish brown. Since we already went kind of neutral, I wanted to give it a little peachy tone to it. So I went ahead and used this contour shade, and I'm using this along my cheekbones, around my forehead to give it a little bit more depth and warmth and bronziness. I also did already put foundation on. I used the Maybelline Dewy and Smooth in shade Warm Nude 128, and I did contour with the Maybelline Master Conceal in the shade Medium Deep. Now I'm taking the L'Oreal Age Perfect Radiant Satin Blush in the shade Marigold, which is 420. And I'm using this along my cheekbones and right on my nose to give, again, my face a little bit more warmth for this look. Again, guys, please subscribe if you haven't yet. Hit the notification bell so you don't miss any new videos like this. Now I'm taking the Revlon Photo Ready Blurring Powder in shade 020, which I believe is light medium. And I'm using this just to set any areas that I didn't put powder on already. So basically underneath my eye area, on my chin, right underneath where I put the contour along my cheekbones. I'm also putting it on the top of my forehead. Next, I'm taking the Makeup Obsessions Mega Honey Highlighter. This is such a gorgeous highlighter. I just got this gifted to me. And do you see the glow on that, guys? That is just gorgeous. This is like the perfect shade of highlighter for this look. So I'm just using this along my cheekbones, right on the bridge of my nose, and on the tip of my nose, right along the top edge of my lip, and also right underneath my eyebrows to lighten the top of the look up a little bit and bring everything together. Let the eyebrows stand out a little bit more and make sure that everything looks nice, carved, and glowy. Now we are on to the last part. I'm taking the Victoria's Secret Velvet Matte Cream Lip Stain in the shade Bold, the Cheeky Lips Pod in Desert Storm, this one's by the Organic Skin Co., and this lip gloss in Copper, and this is by Libby's That Girl Beauty. It's a translucent, kind of glittery brown, and this is a small business owned company, so you guys can check that out in the description. Everything will be linked down there. I'm taking the Victoria's Secret Lippy, and I'm using this to outline my lips to give it that depth, that definition. I'm bringing it right just above the edge of my lip to make sure they look nice and full. Now I'm taking a little fluffy brush and I'm dabbing on the Cheeky Lip Duo, and I'm just using this to create that ombre effect. I'm bringing it up into the brown so that way it blends in very nicely. And lastly, I'm taking that Libby's That Girl Beauty gloss and just dabbing it over the other colors to give it a nice glossy finish. And this is the final look.
All right, babes, so that was the end of this video. I hope you all enjoyed it and loved it. I hope you enjoyed this makeup tutorial. And if you did, please, again, don't forget to subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you don't miss any new videos like this. Also, don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends, and comment below and let me know if you like cake liner or if you have tried cake liner art yet. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram. And as always, we'll be back next Thursday with another video at 11 a.m. Also, guys, don't forget to stay beautifully awesome. Love you.